You have already logged in to your website, so I'm going to show you that. So let me again share the screen. Okay, do you see the screen? Do you see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is I guess you must have got something .nictonspec.com as a ERP Next website, the ERP Next instance, what we call it. Now you could see that, you know, there is something here. I think this is more like a looks like a website, and you can actually develop it like a website. And we also show the tools available to make this as a website, and then you could log in. So you ERP Next can develop as an ERP as well as your website. So that's an advantage of having it. And obviously, when you have website, if you want to have a very simple website, you may not need ERP Next, obviously. But this will be very useful if you're also putting some e-commerce kind of functionality, shopping cart kind of functionality. And we'll see certain features are available in ERP Next for you know, putting shopping cart kind of functionality, e-commerce kind of portal using this this website facility in ERP Next. So let us log in, and I'm sure you also have got login. So please log in on your instance as you are hearing this. So I have a login here. Okay, and once you log in, you get to see what is called as a desk here in ERP Next. So this is the place where we are actually going to do all our work. Okay, so the right hand side you will see your profile and those kind of things. So that we will anyway look at it. There's a bell sign here, which nowadays we know that bell sign means notification. So we don't need to really kind of think too much about it. What you see on the left hand side is kind of a column with various links over there. And what I'm going to do next 10-15 minutes, just give a walkthrough of what this software provides. Let me just admit people. So obviously the first one is home, where now this interface has changed over the versions. Every version comes up with some interesting enhancements or improvements, addition of features. So here we get what is called the UR shortcuts, and basically these are like you click on it to reach that particular page. And then reports and masters, and you'll see accounting, stock, human resources, CRM, data import, and these are like the basic features out here. Then what are these are called the modules. So you see accounting. Okay, and remember that we discussed accounting as one of the business functions. So you see accounting over here. And then you see, interestingly, there's something called a wizard sort of thing, which helps you to set up your instance. So here says, let us set up your accounts and taxes. And they have given some kind of a tutorial for it. To do it, very well designed tutorial, so it's very easy for people to go ahead and you know, look at this. Okay, so but obviously downstairs we have a UR shortcuts, and then there are reports and masters. So you would see that this is kind of a format that they have got, right? Then you go to assets. Assets, as we have seen in balance sheet, we see the assets like fixed asset. We talked about that in last session. Again, here ways to set up asset model. Then there are shortcuts, and then there are reports and masters that we have for asset model. This is another model that we have. This is a build model. Build model is not really a business function per se. Build model is where you can define different modules, different models, and so on. This is more technical, so really wanted to cover in the functional training. But this is something useful for customizing ERP Next for a particular company. Then comes buying, also known as purchase or procurement. You see a wizard kind of a thing for you to set up buying for you. Then you got shortcuts. Then you got reports and masters. Then you got a CRM. CRM stands for customer relationship management. It actually has three parts to it generally when you talk about CRM. There is a sales force automation called SFA, sales force automation, which is nothing but sales pipeline over here. So basically, how if you have many sales people, let us say you have hundreds of sales people, you need to manage them and you need to manage the entire sales funnel or pipeline. We'll talk about that as when we come out that when we come for the discussion. So sales pipeline is one aspect of it. You also need to worry about customer complaints and all that. So support is another model which is not shown as a CRM model here, but many times CRM products do include that as a sub model. And then there are marketing automation or campaign part of it. So ERP Next provides most of the CRM functionality which is available. However, CRM was more used for analytics. And there's some analytics which is coming in sales analytics, which comes in CRM. And the evolution of the whole ERP system is going towards having more and more analytics. So as I said, if you look at ERP is what? It's nothing but just a very lot of input forms where you enter data and you see a lot of reports. But the reports are typically static. So now the focus is to come up with analytics. And when you say analytics, there are three things that we typically talk about. One is called descriptive analytics, which is nothing but reports. Like you talk about here, reports like lead details, sales funnel, and inactive customers or campaign efficiency kind of a thing. These are what are called descriptive analytics, which has been there. I mean, before it was called descriptive analytics, it was called MIS reports or reports. So that are all there. In ERP Next, you get descriptive analytics pretty well. What is getting more interesting nowadays is what we call as predictive analytics. Right? Can we predict what would be your sale given the, if you are going to spend maybe some amount in advertising, so something like a 10 lakh rupees in advertising, how much more sales that we can get? So routinely we spend 5 lakh rupees per month. Next month I'm trying to spend 10 lakh rupees. 5 lakh rupees more, we're doubling the advertisement spending. How much impact that will have on the sales? How much more sales can I expect? See how much it will happen, what happen in future. Is something which is called critical, which is not so much here, but will start coming in. You'll see more and more of that happening going forward. And then finally, we're talking about a prescriptive analytics, which says that it's like you go to a doctor. Doctor will give a prescription, saying, do this, take this tablet in the morning, take this tablet in the evening, and so on. Similarly, the system should tell you, you know, that you should spend more in next month if you want to really achieve this kind of a sales target. Or you have got some sales target for a salesperson, and then the system will recommend that you should spend so much on that price. So that's a prescriptive statistic, which is obviously very, very, very interesting. Obviously, more of people are more on the predictive analytics. So that is something which is the talk of the town, so to say. So with CRM, we get with ERP Next, we get some of it, but obviously there's more to do. But yes, it provides a basic system which is required to develop these analytics, right? So you can't do the analytics in air. You need those data out here. So that is something that ERP Next provides. And you can build analytics solutions on top of that. So now let us move on to HR. HR, as we see earlier, it's again business function, and then there are obviously employee, and then there are leave applications, attendance. I remember one of you said that what HR does is basically leave attendance, and you know, leaves and attendance. So all that is part of here. Again, the features may not be as comprehensive as one would need, but for a small and mid-sized companies are more than enough. You can also handle recruitment over here. You can handle training over here. You can handle loans to employees. Some employees take loans from company. Not so much trained nowadays, but earlier people used to take loans from companies, or companies used to pay loans, give loans to people and get the premium deducted from the salary directly. So that feature is supported in here. Next, then we have a loan management system altogether over here. Then payroll is typically a function within, sometimes within HR, sometimes within accounting, depending on the company per se. Sometimes it's actually separate. Many small size companies, mid size company may have a payroll department separately, which will take care of your salary payment essentially. So that is a separate module over here. Then there are projects. So companies do have many projects. So projects are nothing but some kind of initiatives which are taken with some start date and end date. So you may have, like for example, this initiative, which is a training that we're talking about, Orium as a training program. It could be also a project. It's kind of a year-long project where we're deciding to have multiple training programs, training programs for different on different topics, right? So this could be a simple project kind of thing. So some companies execute many such projects, and there are some people working on it. So you need to really have this task and timesheet and so on. In software services business or in construction business, for example, what we do as a delivery is actually projects. So for software services companies, actually projects represent some kind of operations, because what we do day in and day out are actually working on project. Because we're working on a project for a customer. So customer give us some definite work and we kind of make a project plan and execute this project. So that is what the project for construction and software services and few more industries. For others, projects are something which happens like a small thing, you know, something which like a process improvement projects that one may take undertaken. So on. So these are like projects. Then quality, which is another small function, business functions there. Again, I'm sure in software services, in Indictrans, for example, we have quality function. So many companies, particularly managing companies, take quality very seriously, because quality of product, for the matter, every company needs to take quality very seriously. So there is some support for that here. Then comes selling, which is a very critical process in any company, because that brings money, critical business function actually. So again, there is some support for how to set up selling model. Then there are some quick actions or shortcut essentially. It's just that same thing has been said differently, and then reports and masters. Then you have got stock. So stock is nothing but inventory. So it is also called inventory. I would have referred to it as inventory most of the time in earlier sessions. So there is a, and this is very, very important for any manufacturing company, which will have raw materials and consumables and so on. And obviously, even for a services company, you will have some inventory of stationery or something, which is not a very critical thing, but yes, you may want to have some kind of inventory management there too. But in manufacturing company, that matters a lot. In services company, it will be less important. Then support, which some software products include as part of CRM. But basically, it's all about if you want to support a particular product, then you need to have some service agreements and warranty claims and so on. So that is what is covered over here. Website is what we started when we visited the website, and we said there's a blog that you can. Create, there are some pages that we can create, and there could be themes that we could have, and you know, many things out there. So this could externally see in the website, people can see it, and you could, the limits of there are many software available, just create a website, like WordPress is there, Joomla is there, Drupal is there, There are many website software which are available to develop websites. ARPNext provides reasonably good functionality to build a website.
Okay.
So if you really want a very, very powerful website, then you may not want to use ARPNext for that. But if you want a very functional website, if you're a manufacturing company, you want some functional website, you have to show some products maybe and about us and what do we do kind of a thing, then ARPNext is good enough to make that kind of thing. But if you want to create a website which has a lot of content and a lot of features, you want a search engine optimization and those kind of a things, then this is not so much of enough functionality for us to build. Then comes settings, which is not a function per se, just the settings that we need to do in this software. So again, there are reports and masters, and there are quite a few settings. So this, you see account setting, HR setting, support setting. So all those settings which are there in particular model are given here. The reason they are kind of separated out, because sometimes you may have a specific role which will only look at settings. So you want to give that access to settings, and that person can access all settings from one page. Then there are certain utilities which are provided. That is only views which are there. I'm sure some more is coming. Then come domains. Now, when I say domain, it is where the operations part is coming. So education. Education would necessarily mean a school or a college. You would have this kind of functionality, right? Student, you need to set up students, you need to have instructor, there are programs, courses, admission, fees, all those are operations for an education. So that all is supported over here. Then when it comes to manufacturing, talk about production over here, right? So in here, you need to talk about bill of materials, it's called BOM, work order, and so on. So this is all about a manufacturing setup. So what they have, ARPNext has done, is that operations part they have taken out and they call it a domain. So in a domain, what differs is basically the operations part. Okay, the HR remains the same. HR of a manufacturing company, HR of a software company will remain the same. That's almost really the same thing. So those things will remain the same. I'm just admitting Shraddha. So these things will remain the same, and the HR and the selling and buying and those kind of things. The other things will change, which is basically what is covered in the domains. Similarly, you have retail, which is here. And you could actually choose when you're setting up your system that what you want to see in the domains. So you could choose where you want to show retail. So for example, if you're a manufacturing company, you don't want to even see education and retail, so that is possible. Or in a company, you may actually have multiple activities. Like for example, a company could do some manufacturing and they may also do some retail also. So it's not necessary. But if you have a mid-sized company, it is very possible that they do both two, three activities at the same time. So there it makes matters to have this kind of multi-domain settings over there. And then there is a finally administration, which is, we are not going to get into it, but I just show you, you can do some customization, you can customize the form. So whenever you go and implement ARPNext, you know, you just can't implement the vanilla thing. Vanilla means as it is, right? You can't do that because every company will have some process. Like that day we are talking, I think Jayant asked this question that the process that I have shown, you know, in real life, that is not a process that people follow, which is correct. There is no, I mean, every two different companies will have different ways of running a process. Okay, let me admit Avinash. So every company will have its own process, and you need to do some customization for that company. Implementing ARPNext largely involves customization, right? Because if you just install it, this is like a simple thing. Largely involves customization and obviously configuration. So both of these things need to be done. We will more look at configuration in our training program, not so much of customization. So you can also integrate ARPNext with various software products like Dropbox for backup, Google Drive backup. Then you could also do some authentication thing. So you could have a separate server for authentication, like Active Directory kind of software. Then you may have WooCommerce and Amazon or Shopify kind of e-commerce things where you want to connect. Abhijit is joining in. Then payments, there are different payments, things like PayPal, Razorpay, and you can connect to them, and you have some additional webhooks kind of. We'll not get into this, but those who are technical people in this class will obviously play with some of it, because this is again required when you are implementing RPA Next, for example. So there are some payment related Razorpay, so you need to integrate with Razorpay. So those things will get. There are certain tools like do email, some automation that you can do, some event sharing that you can do. And finally, there are users. Okay, so right now we have only got two users in every instance. One is administrator and name. So administrator is a by default user which is get created when you start install PRP Next. And then you can add more users. It is always a good idea to add at least one more user, so that you don't log in using administrator, you log in using the user, and you may have similar privileges like what administrator has. And you have multiple users, like you'll have people in accounting, they are users. So all employees are typically users, okay, or are typically users. Some of the users may not be employees, I mean, what we call the website user. So you got system user and website user. System users are typically employees, so all employees, we expect them to have a user ID password so they can access systems. But there could be some website users. You could also have some suppliers and vendors who could access a website for accessing some limited functionality. So you could define those kind of users also separately. You could have some people on contract where you can also give user ID password to them. So they can also have users. So you need to really manage this users management. You need to do through this kind of a model. So there are so many of models like this. Kind of a quick walkthrough is what I've given. And let me take a pause now to see if there are any questions. Is this clear to you, or do you have any questions? Okay. So now what we'll do, we'll now come back to our story. So I kind of promised you that I'll be telling a story, right? So let me what calls a case in the typical management education parlance, but basically a story that we'll be following throughout this training program. So we are talking about an entrepreneur. Let us name her Sharvari. So we're talking about a story of a Sharvari who has started her business, and she has started a business with some capital, some investment from her personal savings. So let us assume that she is in her 30s and she started a kind of a business. And the business that she has started is basically selling laptops and desktop and some portable drives kind of thing. And what she does, instead of selling like a being a common retailer kind of a person, she's actually started a kind of branding her own product. So she has one product, which is a laptop, which is basically Sharvari laptop, which essentially means a laptop with a mouse and, you know, put in the back kind of a thing. So it sells the whole package essentially. And these laptops are typically refurbished. They're not really branded in a way. They're typically refurbished. But so she also includes installation and maintenance and support kind of services along with that. Similarly for a desktop, she kind of package everything, CPU, a monitor, a keyboard, a mouse, or even a portable drive thrown in there, you know, and she does the installation and also gives support. So again, they are refurbished, kind of assembled kind of things. And that's the one product that she has. And then she has some portable drive kind of thing. So she has started this business with, say, 10 lakh rupees investment, kind of owner's equity, so to say. And she has bought some of them from her friend, or she has got a friend to do all this manufacturing for her. So she has started with, so she kind of tied up with one of her friend to manufacture it or to assemble it for her. So she has started with buying some laptop, some desktop, some print drives, some portable hard drive. This is what she has built some inventory, and she has started this business. And she was told that, you know, ERP Next is a very great software, and she should use ERP Next to maintain it, to track it, because there are many tax implications, and you know, you also need some good CRM in place and so on. So there are various reasons why you should kind of use this. So that's the reason she has started using ERP Next. So she's like any other company. She has not started ERP Next on day one, right? I mean, when you start a business, it's very unlikely that you start with some software. She has started a business, and then, but before getting into any selling or buying, she has kind of started using ERP Next, which is again shows that she's pretty tech savvy, that she wants to start using software almost like from day one. So we have, she has got a bank account, she has got some inventory, so to say, and obviously she has some money in the bank account, because which is basically her investment. So that is what she has got, and she is now getting into, you know, starting up ERP Next. And she has already got some list of customers and suppliers. So she has already got some customers whom she knows and who are going to buy from her. So she has already got that customer list. She also got some supplier list, and she also knows that she will be having some items. So what is happening? That she knows that she's not going to manufacture on her own to begin with, but eventually she wants to manufacture, assemble these things. So she's going to keep track of all those raw material, so to say, all work in progress kind of thing, the sub-assemblies sort of it. And she's going to track obviously all finished goods, so to say. So she wants to set up all that in the system right now. So when she start using them, it should be available to her. So this is what typically some manufacturing companies will do. So they will have suppliers, they will have customers, they will have some items, you know, which are there in stock, and so on. So that is all what will do it. So we'll call this company as Sharvari Computers. And again, the name Sharvari per se is my choice, but you could pick up any other name. You could do your own name. Like, you know, you could pick up like Siley, Computers, or Swati Computers. You could name it anything that you want, and go ahead and start working on it. So what we're going to do is that we'll first set up this thing, this company. So let us say Sharvari is setting up this company in ERP Next. So we will act like a Sharvari or whatever name you take it up, say Sagar, and then set up this thing. So first we'll set up a company in ERP Next, and we'll go a little realistic in terms of having something to begin with, not something to scratch, but something to begin with. And then we will have our first sales order coming in, and we'll deliver to that sales order. So we'll do that. So when you do delivery of sales order, we'll go through the entire process of selling, like invoicing and receiving payment and all that. Then we will get another sales order, second sales order. And this time we'll realize that we need to first purchase something. And so we'll purchase something and then deliver that sales order. So that's the second thing that we'll do. And if time permits, we'll also try to do that. We get a third sales order where we actually get into assembling things. So high time to start our own assembly. So we'll start assembling things, we'll do that operations and then deliver that sales order. So that's the third thing. So we'll try to do these three cycles, three sales cycle actually. But the first sales cycle is just, we already have some inventory, we just sell from that inventory. The second time when we get a sales order, we'll purchase something and then deliver. And third time, when we're saying selling, we're actually manufacturing. So we're kind of growing now. So we'll, and again, the values that we'll see are also kind of growing. So that is what we will be living this story. So the story will now start, and then we'll kind of, throughout those sessions, we're going to do this one after another. So that is what the plan for this session. As I said, we want to do three, but we'll see how it goes. And if you can do three, great. But otherwise, even if you do two, I'm sure you'll get some very good idea of how to use ERP Next, and you get a fairly good idea what we know about ERP Next. In the process, I'll keep on touching, saying that there are things like product variant we are not going to look at in a training program. There are things like this we're not going to look at, all that. The reason I'm going to tell you not to tell, you know, what we are not going to cover, but just to tell you that there are so many things in ERP Next which are difficult to cover in a typical training program. And you may not even need to know to begin with. But when you get into a project, that project may require this particular functionality, in which case you should go and understand it. Understanding the ERP as a whole in and out will not really make sense for us, because we may not be working on all aspects in our upcoming project. So we'll try to understand the basics or the core functionality, as we say, 80%, that will be used 80% of time. And then remaining we'll learn on job basis. I mean, as and when required, kind of thing. So whenever you're getting in a project, that product, the project uses a particular feature, you'll obviously learn. So we'll not really learn that in this training program, but this is what is used most of the time. So we'll learn that. Now, you have got in our group, I'm sure everybody's in the group. Is there anybody who's not in the group, in our Telegram group? Just raise your hand if you're not in the Telegram group. There are 28 people, but I think Telegram group has less number of people, so I'm sure there must be some hands raised. Okay, so nobody's raising hand, I'm not sure why. But okay, so in the Telegram group, I have posted one Excel file, which is part one. Let me open that Excel file and share with you. You can also open it in your on your machine. So my desktop laptop has become very slow, so it's taking time to open it. But you can open it in your. Let me just stop presenting. Okay, so it is opened. Okay, so let me do one thing. Let me share my entire screen. That will be easier for me to work with. Yes, Vaishali, you're not in the group.
Yes, sir, I'm not in the group.
Yeah, so I guess it was just please join the group.
It's
group.
Not so. It's not uploading me. Allow me to access that group.
Okay, so you're not in the Telegram group, is what you're saying, right?
Yes.
Yes, so fair enough. So you can now watch this thing, but after the session, please join the group. And I think in Telegram group, even if you join later, you can access whatever has been posted earlier. So just check that up. So you'll get that file. If you don't, you can just send me a message and I'll send it to you. So, okay. But this is, yeah, so this is what I wanted to kind of start with. So this Excel is anyway sent to you, so you don't need to really make any notes. It's all available to you. So this is what I am proposing. And, okay, so let me tell you typically how I would do a training program. Typically, I would take this Excel sheet and say this is the data. I would enter this data. I mean, as we are doing setting up this servering computers on the ERP Next, I will enter this data. I will show this is how to enter data. And then I'll tell everyone to enter this data. And then we kind of go along with it. So we'll do this thing and we'll follow along with it. However, in this particular training program, where I see a lot of you are already on ERP Next and kind of very comfortable with ERP Next. What I propose is that if you know ERP Next well, you know, you need not follow exactly the way I'm doing. Okay, you could do some enhancements in a way. So you could actually go ahead and put more products. You may do something different. You could do something more, not less, but something more. So instead of adding 4 customers, you may add some 5 customers, 6 customers. You may add some more details about that customer. So you could do something different in case of whatever data is there. And you could also take some different numbers. So I have given some numbers. As we go along, I'll also give some different numbers altogether. So you could take some different numbers also. If you want to, or if you can take different territories, and as we go on, you've got some items, some numbers over here. So you could change those numbers, okay? But the only thing that you need to do is that you should not, or rather you should keep track of what differences that you're following. So if you have Excel, you can enter what kind of data that you're entering there. Because if you get get stuck somewhere, and if you want me to help you, then I should be able to see what have you entered. Okay, so from that perspective, you should keep track of what are the changes that you are doing. But please feel free, because I know some of you are already working with ERP Next much, and you may get a little bored if you just follow what I'm doing. So you could make some changes as you want. But just keep track of those changes so that if there is an issue, we could resolve that issue. Okay. So, but those who are absolutely new to ERP Next, doing it for first time kind of a thing, they could simply follow me. I mean, we will do it together. Regardless of that, I will also tell you something to do it on your own. I will not do it. I'll just say, okay, now this is the way to do it. Now go ahead and do it kind of a thing. And in that process, you make some mistakes wherein I would help you to resolve. So don't worry about making mistakes. As a matter of fact, just to add some spice to this training program, we will do some mistakes deliberately. I mean, so that we learn something more interesting. So don't think that it's going to be a very boring thing where you just see some Excel data entering in this ERP Next. It will become very interesting because things will not tally, something will go wrong. And then you need to really struggle to see where things have gone wrong. So we'll do some few mistakes by design, and you will make some more mistakes, not by design, but they just happen. So in a way, you will have some mess, which will clear up as we go along. So that is how it will do a learning. The reason I generally say this and generally do this way, because otherwise, one, it becomes boring. And second, you don't learn so much because you're just following blindly. Okay, 4 customers, add karna hai, chalo add karte. You know, ye karna hai, chalo ye karte. So it's become like a, kind of, in college used to say, ratta marna jaisa cheez hoti hai. Just kind of follow what is being said. I don't apply your brain for it. So I wanted to think through, and at any point of time to see that something I'm doing is not correct, please tell me that I'm not doing correct. Sometimes I may be doing it by design, and I will really appreciate that you can find it out. Great that you found some mistakes. Sometimes I make some mixing mistake, which also is helpful if you can find it out. So it's going to be a little roller coaster ride, so I don't want you to take it lightly. I want you to do changes. So if you find this is getting boring, I would expect you to some change the numbers, change the data, do the way you want to do this. This is your story. You are setting up, say, something like Radhika computers or Nupur computers or something like that. So you may decide that, okay, instead of having starting with 100 laptops, let me start with 3,500 laptops and, you know, get a sales order of in crores and not in lakhs of rupees and work with it, which is perfectly fine. So we have some numbers which are very simple, small numbers, but if you want some high numbers to be used, different numbers to be used, please do so. Okay, so that is important because then this training program will become interesting. Okay, so so we are now setting up this thing. So first of all, we should go look at accounting. So now, so let me actually run through the Excel what we have. So this is part one. Part two will come for sales cycle one. Part three will come for sales cycle two. And part three will come for sales cycle three. So that's how we will have part one, part two, part three. So we'll do part one. We'll see whether we can do it today. Otherwise, we'll do it in next session. So in part one, we're going to set up customers. Okay. So what this company Sharvari Computers have got is that sir got some 6 customers, and I just put some name, customer 01, customer 02. You may like to put some interesting names there. Okay, so the customer 0 is a company, so you may want to say Acme Private Limited, something like that. Just put some interesting names. Don't need to really follow this. What you need to see is that each of these companies are type. So some are company, that is business to business, or some are individuals. Okay, so that is what the type of customer is. Then there are groups of customers. So what is group? So in marketing, we follow a concept called segmentation. So we try to see that how my customers are. So there are, I may have hundreds of customers, or I may have 10 customers or 20 customers, or I may have millions of customers. So there could be many, many customers that you may have, but we try to build some kind of segment. And you see, who are they? So platinum are those customers in this particular case, are the people who would buy at a high price, or they are the people who would not be very price sensitive in a way. They are perhaps give more business to you, a very high volume business to you. And the other that you want to have, you know, they are buy in bulk and they want to, they don't really negotiate so much, but they want good service for that matter. So all that is there with the platinum. So we call this a platinum customer. So some of my customers are platinum. Some of my customers are gold, who are buy in less quantity maybe, but little more price sensitive maybe. But yes, it's good to have. And then there are silver, there are customers, there could be actually many in number, who would have, you know, very price sensitive maybe, you know, they don't buy so much, but you know, they are there. So why do you want to really discriminate or kind of differentiate between these groups? Because if somebody's buying to, you know, a lot of volume, or to give a lot of business to you, then you want to treat them separately than the customers who are not giving as much business. So there's nothing like you don't want to serve silver customers or something like that. But there are certain customers who want to serve specially. Right? You want to serve them, give them, you know, some special treatment. So you may go in a bank, for example, say ICICI Bank. You will see that there are some kind of privilege banking. So they have customers who are, you know, who have maybe thousands of rupees in their bank accounts, who are the regular customers. And then there are customers who have lakhs of rupees in their accounts, maybe 10 lakhs plus. They are privileged banking kind of customers. And then there are people who have crores of rupees of business with ICICI Bank. And then they become their kind of very special or called HNI, high net worth individuals, and so on. So they will give some special service to them, right? So that is our whole idea about customer groups or segmentation. Obviously, we're not learning marketing in so much detail, but this is a very important concept in marketing called segments, because you really want to segment these customers. The second thing is territory, which also could be a segment. So some cases, you could get territory as a separate segment or customer groups, but territory is specifically geography. So here we have got domestic. And Sharvari knows that her current business is only coming from West India, which is Maharashtra, Gujarat, Goa. But she wants to set up a territory where it says that I have a domestic and I have North, South, East, West. So North India, East India, West India, South India. And she wants to also put international territory. And then she has to say Southeast Asia, Gulf, European Union, UK and USA. So we know most of our orders. Yes.
Sir, we are not getting that Excel sheet from the group, Telegram group.
It's there in the Telegram. You are not seeing the Excel sheet? Or, I'm sorry, I didn't get you what you said.
I'm not getting it, sir, from the group. Means I'm unable to find it.
I think you haven't shared it, sir.
Yes.
It's not in. It's not Telegram.
No, it is not.
Oh, okay. Let me do that right now. Okay, so let me do one thing. Let me not hurry it in a way. We will just go through this Excel sheet as we are sharing it. And I'm sure you can see this Excel sheet in the shared screen. And I'll show you where to set the data. And then I will share the Excel sheet on the group. If there's an issue there, I'll check it out. And you can use the Excel sheet to enter data later outside the session. So I'm not expecting you to enter the data during the session, so that you can do after this session. And if you're in difficulty, you can post it and we'll see those issues in next session. Will that work?
Okay, sir.
I don't know, I just uploaded it, but anyway, I'll check it up for presentation. Okay, so this is a territory that we are kind of setting up here. So it's like a tree, like a structure. So we have domestic, international, and then there are things. And then there are customers where we talked about, you know, each customer will give a group and a territory. So to begin with, you have to first set up customer groups, then you have to do territory, and then you have to do customers kind of thing. And there are many things in customer that we can put in, but we are just putting some few things here. So let me just go back again to our ERP text. One way you can go through models, but very quickly figure out that it is not very great way to do it. There is a search bar which is very powerful. I think it's called Avsum search or something, which is really very good one. And here you can simply put customer group. So I just type it here, customer group, and it says customer group tree. I just click there. And I should get a screen where I can see the customer group. Your system is being updated. Please refresh again after a few moments. Okay, there seems to be some updates going on. Let's try again. Okay, looks like there's some challenge in the system. So we'll wait for a few minutes. Let us look at other data and come back here. So this is the customer data. We'll see how to enter that data. Then let us look at suppliers. And we're talking about supplier. So again, supplier, we have some kind of type that we could have. So we could have suppliers which provide raw materials, suppliers for freelancers, suppliers for giving some products, some utilities, and so on. Again, for Shalvari Computers, she doesn't really need so much, you know, thing. She may only need to say products as a supplier, right? But when you are setting up ERP Next or any ERP software, you don't want to get limited on what you have. But how do you really want to plan? So it's enterprise resource planning. Right? So you also want to say plan. And that's the reason, you know, she has chosen to, or you could choose for her in terms of picking up all the types of possible supplier types. Some are used now, some are used later, but we kind of have all these supplier types over here. And then she will simply go ahead and put this supplier 0, 1, 0, 2, 10. Again, as I said, you can always give some good names, with some more meaningful names, some interesting names to this. Just ensure that you pick up at least 2-3 types so that it will make meaningful. And some way to figure out, you know, this is raw materials kind of thing. And we can add some contacts over this. So contacts is a separate thing. So it's contact is a person. So typically we're expecting a supplier to be a company. So you need to define some contacts. So that is what we will do. So once the system comes up, I'll kind of show you how to do this. Then come item. In item, first we have to define warehouses. Now, warehouse would typically mean kind of a buildings where all the, you know, inventory is stored. So inventory could be raw material, could be work in progress items, some assemblies kind of thing, and or it will be finished. Okay, or it could be finished goods. So we could have these different warehouses. So as I said, a typical warehouse would be a building where you have all those things stored. But when it comes to ERP Next, we don't have that limited definition of warehouse. In ERP Next, warehouse essentially means a storage location. So you could have, for example, an office as a warehouse. So that is perfectly possible. You could have, and again, you can have a tree, like the way we saw for other things. we could have a tree. We could have a tree where you say that is an office, is a cupboard which has a shelf, and it has a box, and all that you can define in the warehouse. So the warehouse is a term which means something specific. In ERP Next, it actually means like a storage location. Okay, so we should keep that in mind. Then we could have many items. Okay, now you see this list. Let me zoom it a little bit. Again, I have put very unimaginative names like part A, part B kind of a thing. It's a raw material. Then SA1, SA2. You could change these names. Please feel free to do that. Only thing I have got is a portable drive, laptop, and desktop is a product which we are talking here. And we again have a consumer 01, consumer 02, consumer 03. So this could be like a stationery, like pens and papers and those kind of a things. So these are consumable 01. So you could actually put something like a pens and stationery, papers, and those kind of notebooks kind of a thing. And then there are services like maintenance, installation, upgradation, software support, consulting, and so on. So you could have those kind of things. So you could need to create these items, item name. Then we have item group. So we need to create these item groups, by the way, so that I have not shown here. But we need to create item groups. So that's another thing. There are three item groups. Raw materials of assemblies, products, consumable, services. These are what we say as item groups. So that we need to define. You may give some description which is useful when you are listing these products on a website. So the description will be very useful there. But for the time being, we are not going to get into that. But you may provide some description. There's a unit of measurement that you need to provide. So again, we are taking some randomly anyway. If you are giving some real names, then you should put a meaningful unit of measurement. For example, for consumables, you are saying notebooks, then you put as a numbers. Right? So just ensure that you are putting the right unit of measurement first. We will say there is a checkbox which says maintain stock. So you should maintain stock for all of this product except services. The services we don't maintain stock. So maintain stock means you are maintaining inventory of those items. There is also called include item in manufacturing. So we'll say yes for raw material, not for any other. So we'll say that. Then we need to give default warehouse where it should be located. So that we have defined RMAs and those kind of thing. Consumables, we are actually putting in the raw material still, just for our presentation. Then there's a GST, which is tax, which I don't want you to enter right now. It is just there for one purpose. We will discuss about taxation separately because that requires some good understanding of how GST works, and so we'll discuss that a little later. Okay, I hope the system is up by now. Just see. What happened with others? Are you also getting this message in your system? Anybody has logged in and checked?
Sir, call the URL again. Log out and login, sir.
Okay. I think it is coming, looks like. Oh, it came now. Okay, perfect. So it is coming. So let me just go back to customers. Customer groups. There are already some groups over here, already defined, kind of. What I wanted to do is you delete those and create this customer group platinum, gold, silver. So you should delete this and create a new one. So create new one, you have this new button here and you can click on it and just put a customer group name. If it's a tree, you want to say group node, click on it and then you can create further nodes. And if you have to delete, you can just go ahead here and delete and just get rid of. The reason I want to delete something and add something new, because that's how we will start working with the system per se. Then territory, again, you can go ahead. So by the way, you could do all this by model, but as I told, most of the time, we will not do that. You'll go with search. So you do territory. Again, there are India and rest of the world. We want it this way, domestic, international. So you could either rename it, you can call it India as domestic, and make it as a node, so that you could you could actually create a territory, kind of create some kind of a tree over here. So you have to create a tree. You know, in custom group we are not creating tree. So tree is possible there, but in territory you want to create a tree. So just create this tree in customers. So this is obviously you should do it after the session, not during the session. I'm just telling you because I've not shared this Excel. So let me just explain what we need to do. Then customer 01, customer 02. So you need to go to customer and you see a customer list here. And then please ask me questions if you get any doubts in between. Don't wait. Please ask questions if you have any. So here you get a customer list. Obviously, it is all empty right now. So you only create a new customer and you click on it. Here you see a new customer thing, and you could actually put a full name. You could say the type is individual or company. You could actually have a customer group. Again, once you create your customer group, the platinum and all that, you will see it here. So you need to have that. Territory, the same thing. You will need to first create there, then you will see it here. Primary contact is you may choose to put in or you may not. Depends. I mean, we are not insisting that we should do, but you may want to do it. It's a good idea to edit in full page because you have to see many more attributes of customers, what you can do. Whatever I have given are minimal. This is, must be there to begin with. But I would suggest you to look at other. I would recommend that you should edit in full screen. I think what are the things out there? So here you see account manager for that customer. And you could see some names coming here so that you could pick up. Those are typically your employees. Account manager is a man who is in touch with the customer, talk to the customer. Obviously, in our case, we do not, may not have those many people, but in a large company, you would have specific dedicated account managers who would talk to that customer. So everybody in the company will not talk to the customer. Typically, it will go through account manager. And customer also talk to the account manager. So that is how you would do it. And then there are type, and there's a GST category, which is specific to India, and we'll discuss this a little more in next session. So there's a PAN and tax ID and those kind of things that you could put in. As you can see, there are many, many things that are out here. We will discuss few of them as we go along. Okay, some of these we will not necessarily talk because there are so many topics. Currency and price list, this is what we'll discuss later, but we need to look into this. Then primary address, then you have some accounting over here, credit limit and payment terms are here. There could be loyalty program that we could have, so that information is here. So you could see that ERPNX provides a good kind of comprehensive form for you to insert a lot of details associated with this. But when you actually go and start implementing ERPNX, you will see there are 20 more things that you need to store here. That is where we mean by customization of the forms or doc type. That you need to add some more details actually, because many companies will have very specific details that are captured. In a very small company, you may not have these many details. You have just few details and you are done with it. But in large companies, you have a lot many details that will come in there. So that is about customer. Similarly, I'm sure you can check out supplier type. So let us do that. So I'm just typing supplier type. It's not there. So this is supplier. And this is supplier group list. So supplier type is perhaps not correct. We should say supplier group, which is very similar to what we are doing for supplier customer group. So it's just alignment. So there are already some groups available. I want you to delete all these groups and then create this group. So we'll call it a supplier group. Snehal, you have a question? Okay, no problem. So we could have created a supply group. So I want to delete whatever is out here and create new supply group, what we have shown in the Excel. If you want, you can continue with this. The reason you need supply groups is, again, you may have certain policies for supply groups. So certain suppliers are, more trusted than others, perhaps, and you may want to give some better credit terms to them. So you may still want to create those supply groups. And many times, supply groups are also useful for reports. So you want to find your spend analysis, which, where are you spending more? Spending more on raw materials or consumables and all that. So from that perspective, supply groups comes very handy. So good idea to define the supply groups. We could use it as it, whatever is given the Excel. There's already a list over there. You can change this. Edit this if you want to, and you may want to or delete some of it and create a new list. Your choice, you can do either one of it. Then comes supplier. So again, I go ahead, click here and say supplier. Yes, supplier list. You don't see anything over here in supplier list. So you create your first supplier. What you need is a supplier and a supplier group. And it's a supplier type, but again, if you edit in full page, you could have many things which are out here. There are quite a few things, just settings out here. I'll explain this as we go along. So you have similar things for you see customer, you have here like credit limit and currency and prices and so on. So those things we're not look at right now. We will just need some supplier name, supplier group. And you can create a contact here. So you need to kind of create a contact about the suppliers. So that we'll need to kind of figure out how to do that, but we'll create a contact for the supplier. So let us do that later. And then item. So item is, by the way, an important, I think the most important data that we need to put in. Particularly so for a manufacturing company, because it's kind of a thing that you kind of track. So it's a thing in a stock model where you track the items. And it could have lots of information. It could have lots of information. We are again not getting into so much of details. What we are putting, maybe item code and item group and those kind of a thing. But if I open in full page, you will see a lot of this. Which makes sense, because that's actually the thing that you want to work with. You will see your maintenance stock and include item in manufacturing as things. It could be valuation rate, is it GST, non-GST, the inventory. There are different valuation methods which we have talked about. There's sometimes auto reorder. In some cases, you could also want to reorder based on, if for example, we have got some consumable, we pick it, maybe hundreds of them, but moment it reaches that level, as you start consuming, the level reaches something like 20 or 30 or something like that, then you want to reorder. So you could have that kind of things out here. And then there are purchase replenishment details, supply details, foreign trade details, sales details. So you would have seen that ERP Next is very, very, provides a very good user experience in a way. So that whenever you want to create some new item, new customer, it will pop up a dialog box which will ask very specific, very minimal details to begin with. Then you can edit in full screen and you can see so many details, but these are all kind of collapsed format. You can expand each one of them and start seeing that you know what needs to be applied here. So for example, item tax, you can put it here and you can add rows and so on. So a lot of details can be stored in your Phoenix. And to begin with, you may start small, just put some items here or there just to go along with it. And then as you get more and more expert, you start understanding each of these sections. Okay, so that is how the software is structured, very well structured. So this is what we say master data that we're putting. Customers, if customers were suppliers, and sorry, customer groups, territory, customers, then your supplier groups, suppliers, then item groups. You should get item group, by the way, item group, warehouses, and then items. So this is what we call as a master data, which is a necessary data to start with. Okay. Any question? Let me take a pause here and see if there are any questions. Is it making sense? I mean, I've been talking, but I just want to know, is it making sense to you? So the question from Gupteshwar. So Gupteshwar, can we expect the participants to do this kind of a setting up a data outside the sessions, or should they do it during this? For example, the data that I've shown them, I will be sharing the Excel sheet. Can I ask them to enter this data before they come for the next session? I think this is a question of Gupteshwar or Kanaya.
Yeah, that should be fine. I mean, that's not a problem.
So we don't really spend
basic
time.
Master data. Yeah, master data they can set up. I mean, any very crucial data which needs any guidance or something, then that may be addressed in the session. Or any question very specific that could be addressed.
So that we can kind of move faster in a way. And I'm assuming that all of you know how to enter data in terms of, you know, when you say how to create a new record, so it's a new button here, you know how to, when to click save and those kind of things. So I hope this is understood. I mean, all are enough tech savvy to do it. But if you have any challenges, if you're finding some difficulty, you can post that queries in the group. And you know, not only me, anyone of in the group can actually help you with. Is this fine? Any questions so far? Do you think you'll be able to do it? Or do you see a challenge? Please say it now. Is it doable? Please raise your hand. If you say it is doable, you can do it. Please raise your hand. I think yes in the chat box, but I really want to see a show of hands. So I see Vaishali raising hand. So please raise your hand if you think it is doable, not very complicated. We can do this. So I see only three hands raised. What about others? Okay, what about others? So if you have any difficulty, will you please unmute and say? So if you have any difficulty, please unmute and tell what could be the difficulty you foresee in doing it. So if you're not raising your hand, you should tell what is the problem that you foresee in entering this data in your ERP extensions. I don't see Ashutosh, Ashish raising their hand. Anirudh not raising hand. Dhananjay, I guess you will need to have access to ERP next instance. So once you get, I guess you should be able to do it. So please raise your hand if you're confident that you can do this. Then only I can proceed further. Otherwise, I need to show you how to do it in the session. So I really want you to raise hand if you think you can do it, whatever I said so far, with variations, if any. So what about Swati, Snehal, Tylee? Okay, I don't see many hands not being raised. Nupur. Please, the reason I'm asking you to raise your hand simply because if you see a difficulty, don't get it otherwise. If you see the difficulty in doing this, please tell me now so that accordingly we'll adjust the speed. I'm just trying to do more, so I'm expecting you to do something outside the session. We could do as well in the session, but then we'll obviously go slow. So I just want to adjust the speed. So if you feel that certain things can be done outside the session, then that will be, you know, help us to go a little faster, but not at the expense of not understanding what you're doing. So if you feel you need assistance in the session to show, you know, how to do it, and you want to do it along with me, then we can do it that way. No issues with that. But I want you to say so. I don't want to assume that you need assistance. I want you to say so that you need help. If you feel you can do it, please raise your hand. Okay, so Nupur has raised hand, it is doable. Yes. Okay, great. So I'm still seeing not some people are not doing it, but they are not even saying the problems. I really don't know. In online courses particularly, it has a challenge that sometimes you see the name there, but the person may not be sitting there. So that could be possible. But assuming that you are there and assuming that you can do it, I see many hands raised. If you have any difficulty, please put it in the group. And I'm sure someone or other or myself will help you with it. So with this, let me just move on to the next two tabs, next two worksheets. Now, this is what is called a stock reconciliation. And this is what we'll do in next session. Okay. I don't want you to do it outside the session, because I need to give you some understanding of what is stock reconciliation. So I'll do that in next session. So that's the reason, but I'm showing you what is there. So we are just putting, so as I said in the story, that Sharvari has already some 10 portable drive, 5 laptop and 10 desktops. Okay, so we need to account for that in ERP Next, that is something already there. Okay, she also has some consumer 01. This could be files, or this could be notebook, something like that, but it's already there with her. So that also we need to account for in it. Okay, how do we do that is something that we will see. So this next two tabs are basically looking at accounting model, because when we are going ahead and setting up this company, if the company does not have anything done in the past, then you don't need to do this opening entries or stock reconciliation. Okay. Only when you have done something, then you need to do that. And this could become very complex. Okay. So for example, you already have some assets, okay, which are got depreciated, or you have already some sold to customers and you're expecting some money from customers. Some invoices are generated, but you have not got the cash, right? You got a revenue, but not the cash. You also bought something from your vendors, but not paid them. Okay. So there could be various such things would be there. So whenever you go and implement ERP Next, opening entries, or what we say opening balance in accounting books, is very important. Many times people will move from, say, Tally or say FoxPro kind of a thing to ERP Next. In that case, you just can't say that, you know, we will forget what has been done so far, we'll start something new. That is not really possible. So you have to close all that is there in this old books and move to new books and start with some opening balance per se, right? So that opening balance is something that we'll be doing for this company. We are taking a very simplistic scenario that what it has a bank account, it has some equity, stock equity, and it has some stock, okay? That's all. And we will do the opening balance and then we'll start executing sales cycle and all that. But in real life, there could be much more, many more things that you need to do for account opening balance. So you need to be careful about, you know, doing it. So we'll do this simplistic, but I want you to do it in the session, not outside the session, because you need to really understand what you are doing. It's not simply data entry. You need to understand what we are talking here. So from that perspective, we'll do it in next session. Okay. So I just wanted to do these three things: customers, whatever they are, the customers, suppliers, and item. And please put item groups also there. I'll put an Excel and upload it again, so you could have it. Just see what is there in software conversation. That's all. But don't enter it to begin. Okay. Any questions so far? Okay. You can lower your hands. Please lower your hands, all of you. Please lower your hands. So in last session, we were discussing accounting and I kind of left at some kind of confusion point and I was expecting some interaction on the group, but I have not seen much interaction on group. So I really want the group to be more interactive. So I have not purposely resumed from where we stopped last time, because I thought I'd let us change the gears and get into ERP next. But in next session, we will start from where we left last time and from where we left now. Now, so next session we'll talk about some accounting. We will actually look at accounting model in ERP next. We'll also talk about application of funds and source of fund. Okay. And all that is required, because to do a opening balance, you need to understand something in accounting. Okay. So we're not going to become accountant after that training, for sure, because it's a lot more in accounting, but we'll need to understand some basics. So we already understood some basics, but now that we'll start applying in ERP next, in next session. So we'll have a next session, we'll start with some accounting thing. So I want to ensure that whatever we have covered in first two sessions is what you already understood. So I'll be posting some quiz. So it's very important that you also get access to learning portal. I will kind of post a couple of quizzes, actually not one quiz, just to assess how much you understood. So that is act both way, for you to know how much you understood and for me to know how much I could explain. So obviously if you're not scoring well, that indicates that I have not done a good job of explaining. So I may need to do some more in next session. So to enable me to do that, I'll be posting this quiz today, tomorrow. So please complete this quiz. So before Monday session, I should have all its score. So I have some idea of how much you know, so that we can, when you start applying in this context, I at least know that how much you have understood. And it will really help if you can kind of go revise whatever we have discussed so far. Okay, so Ashish is saying, please show us one record field to make sure there are no complications. Okay, I think, sorry, I saw it a little late. So it's already 10:59. Snail also has a similar thing. So could you show us one complete record? Okay, a request to both of you to try this out. As I also said, you need to do setup first. So first try it out to complete. It is simple, take my word for it. But if you have any difficulty, either you directly ping me or ideally you should put in the group. I think that will be really helpful if you can put in the group. And I would actually urge others also to help, in case I don't respond in time others who see the message can kind of quickly respond back. Because I know there are many people in the group who are already know AIP Next. So those who are new can take help from those who already know. So Snehal, Ashish, please try this out. Let us see. If you have any difficulty, please put it in the group. Okay, any last minute questions? We have 1 minute left. Okay, fair enough. So we are closing this meeting today. And please revise whatever we have done so far. Appear for a quiz. Do this data entry in the system. Do the setup basically in the system. And on Monday, we'll do this what we call as opening balance for server computers in that. And I expect you to do it immediately along with me in your ERP next. Yeah. So see you on Monday. Have a nice weekend in between, and see you again on Monday.